next guest is an international comedy superstar whose infectious charm might give Aussie audiences just the boost they need.
Oh, I'm sorry. I don't think either of us read enough books to be talking about this, okay? Why are we arguing about the estate tax? You're a dog walker and I'm a musical theatre major.
With the perfect combo of fearless gags and endless charm, Joel Kim Booster has shot to comedy stardom.
They were wondering where you got your Speedo from.
Did you get it on Amazon?
No, it's an heirloom. It's been in my family for generations.
Not content with conquering stand-up, he's also a natural on-screen, writing and starring in rom-com Fire Island and alongside Maya Rudolph in Loot.
Here we have a folic acid kale smoothie.
Mmm, what flavour is this?
Gin. That's it. That's what I'm tasting.
Now he's finally returned to our shores and is back on stage where he belongs. Lucky us.
Stop it!
You guys are obsessed with me. What, do you want a medal?
Lucky you, inside your Easter egg, it's Joel Kim Booster! Yeah! We are not worthy. good to have you back in the country.
Oh,
now, this time round, I've heard you say that you're dumbing down your show. Is that for our benefit? Is it for your benefit?
I think it's mostly for my benefit, honestly. I don't think I said that, but it is dumb. I mean, the material is dumber than anything I've done before.
You're having a bit more fun with it.
Yeah,
and
I'm
not
a little
being
bit more
so political
fun.
And maybe a bit
no,
more fun.
Yeah, I mean, listen, I've talked so much about my upbringing and my identity and all those things, and I've been doing stand-up for like 14 years, and I'm just sort of now want to talk about the plight of 5'7" guys, you know?
Yeah.
Short men are the most depressed people in society.
Yes. Oh. Thank you.
So I'm not short, but I have a lot of empathy, so.
You've been down here a few times
yes.
now. What do you love the most about Australia?
Yeah. You know what? This show is actually a really good distillation of what I love about Australia because I find that you guys are much chiller and much more, like, you guys have more fun, honestly. Mm. Like, you guys stole, like, all the good parts about America and then said no to all the others, to the guns. And I really appreciate that. Like, honestly, like, your whole penis riff earlier in the show would never happen on American TV.
Thank you so much.
It would never.
We're number one.
Yeah. Spit and Swallow? I mean, honestly, bring Chester back. Yeah. He would never happen in America. He should be president. Yeah.
Like, somewhere Chester is still talking right now. Yeah. He doesn't realize we've stopped that interview.
He'll keep going. Now, I have heard, though, that you're not a fan of one of our animals.
No, so here's the thing, you guys. I think it is a disgrace that this animal is so closely associated with your country. I think the koala bear is detestable. Talk about an animal that brings nothing to the table. Absolutely nothing.
What about kids?
They sleep all day. They're riddled with disease, STDs.
Yes.
They're completely out of it all the time. That sounds like my friend Jared, okay? Like, I don't need a koala bear to experience
that. I would buy a stuffed Jared at the airport on the way out. I would do that.
But what about their fuzzy little ears?
I mean, but there's, like, plenty of other fuzzy little ears that don't have chlamydia, you know? Take your pick. Go to a zoo. Look around.
I don't have fuzzy ears.
Yeah. Not the other one. Now, Joel, you also, other than being just a star in the stand-up comedian world, comedy world, my gosh, I've just lost my brain, but you also now are a star of the film world. Has that been a scary jump going from, you know, stand-up comedy to Fire Island?
It's not so much that it's scary. It's definitely a huge, like, a very different part of my brain that I'm using, but I think, like, it's made stand-up even more important in my life because stand-up is the only part of my life now where there aren't network notes or producer notes or studio notes, and, like, it's completely unfiltered. I get to be, you know, it's just me and the audience, and so, yeah, it's made it really vital as, like, artistically because it can be a slog to get anything made elsewhere with all the hands and, you know, the pot.
Now, unrelated question. I know you've been watching the show. I'm sure you saw before Nick Cody talking with our Bitcoin expert who is jacked!
His neck was wider than his shoulders.
Don't. You can wear the long sleeves all you want. We know. We've seen. You're a fit guy.
I've rolled them up.
Is there a chance you could help just be a spot buddy for Nick, a gym buddy for Nick?
I would love to. I find Australian gym culture so incredible because it's like, they all look so gay, but they're so straight, you know? And that is...
Cheers, Cobra!
Yes!
Exactly.
Sounds good.
Yeah. I'm going to keep eating chocolate at work.
People will watch you squat anytime. You can catch Joel at the Melbourne International Comedy Festival. The details on our website. Please thank Joel Kim Booster.